at it again, and we have another compilation with Trump. Happy 4th, by the way. Hope everyone has a wonderful day today. But let's dive in.
What's the difference between a wet raccoon and Donald J. Trump's hair? A wet raccoon doesn't have $7 billion fucking dollars in the bank.
That's facts.
This is a tough business run for president.
Oh, no, you're a tough guy, Jeb.
And we need to have a leader that is
real tough.
Honestly, I think Jeb is a very nice person. He's a very nice person, but we need tough people. We need toughness. We need intelligence, and we need tough.
Excuse me, am I allowed to finish?
Go ahead, Mr. Trump.
So,
little of your
again,
own medicine there.
I know you're trying to build up your energy,
please.
Jeb, but it's not working.
One at a time.
Yeah. Look.
He said, I know you're trying to build up your energy there, but it ain't working. I love it. Straight savage. The savagery, man. You gotta love it. How can you not love that?
I'm feeling that by the end of this evening, I'm gonna be blamed for everything that's ever happened.
Why not?
It's just awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the law in our country.
Yeah. Because you'd be in jail. Oh!
You've called women you don't like fat pigs, dogs, slobs, and disgusting animals.
Right?
Your Twitter account
only
is
Rosie
several
O'Donnell.
Thing like you're the great. Let me just tell you something, and it's very interesting. You're not bringing up anything new. You know, you're acting like you're the great reporter, blah, blah, blah.
There are four immigrants on the whole
Come on, try getting it out. Try getting it out.
I'll get it out.
I mean, I don't know if you're going to put this on television, but you don't even know what you're talking about. Try getting it out.
I never attacked him on his look, and believe me, there's plenty of subject matter right
now. Oh, yeah, I remember this.
She's supposed to fight all of these different things, and she can't make it 15 feet to her car. Give me a break. Give me a break.
Wait. Hold on, stop it. Who is he talking about? She's supposed to fight all these different things, but she can't make it 15 feet to her car. Was he talking about Nancy? Y'all let me know in the comment section. Oh, man. What's going on? Oh, what happened in that last clip?
All these different things.
This is the clip he was referencing. Whoever this is like wobbling.
Give me a break. She's home resting right now.
I told the women over here, Hillary, you should.
You told me on my radio show, the audio and the transcript are out there on YouTube, that you would release your tax returns.
True.
Are you going back on your commitment?
No, I'm not. First of all, very few people listen to your radio show. That's the good news. Let me just tell you. Which happens to be true. Check out the rating.
You might say, you might talk, your politicians all talk, no action. I've been watching it all my life. You are all talk and no action. What I've seen up here, I mean, first of all, this guy's a joke artist and this guy's a liar. You have a combination.
This guy always goes to
you have
the state.
I was a businessman. I got along with Clinton. I got along with everybody. Yeah. That was my job, to get along with people.
But the simple fact is,
excuse me, one second.
No.
I didn't want to get
you cannot take
more energy tonight. I like that. You've been doing this for 30 years. Why are you just thinking about these solutions right now? For 30 years you've been doing it, and now you're just starting to think of solutions.
Well, actually,
I will bring back jobs. You can't bring back jobs.
Well, once.
Ooh, emotional damage. He's speaking facts. He's like, man, you've been doing this your entire life, and now you're just now thinking of solutions? BS. He's got a great point. He was, you know, where have all these solutions been your entire political career? Yeah, exactly.
It was finally negotiated and the terms were laid out. I wrote about that in...
You called it the gold standard.
About, well, I hope...
You called it the gold standard of trade deals. You said it's the finest deal you've ever seen.
No.
And then you heard what I said about it and all of a sudden you were against it.
I didn't think I'd say this, but I'm going to say it, and I hate to say it, but if I win, I am going to instruct my attorney general to get a special prosecutor to look into your situation, because there has never been so many lies, so much deception. There has never been anything like it, and we're going to have a special prosecutor.
She's a liar.
Bing, bing, bong, bong, bing, bing, bing. You know what that is.
I wanted to challenge you on one of the statements that you made in the tail end of the campaign in the midterms. That
here,
this,
here we go.
That, well, if you
let's
don't
go,
mind, Mr.
Go.
President,
come on.
That this caravan was an invasion. As you know,
I,
Mr. President,
I consider it to be an invasion.
As you know, Mr. President, the caravan was not an invasion. It's a group of migrants moving up from Central America towards the border with the U.S.
Thank you for telling
and
me that.
And why did you characterize it as such?
Because I consider it an invasion.
Hold on. What's the definition of invasion? Unless there's like a different definition, then technically I would assume that is an invasion, an unwelcome intrusion into another's domain. That's an invasion. So I was correct. I was like, unless there's like some other definition of it that I'm not aware of, that's technically an invasion. So he's not wrong. That reporter needs to open up the dictionary.
Why did you characterize it as such?
Because I consider it an invasion. You and I have a difference of opinion.
But do you think...
It happened a few days ago.
Triple kill!
They're hundreds of miles away, though. They're hundreds and hundreds of
you
miles away. That's not an invasion.
I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings would be
much
better.
One of the worst Secretary of States in the history of the country. She talks about me being dangerous. She's killed hundreds of thousands of people with her stupidity.
505 million. And by the way, I don't like this mic. Whoever the hell bought this mic system, don't the son of a bitch to put it in, I'll tell you. These people. No, this mic is terrible.
He hit my hands. Mic, right. Nobody has ever hit my hands. I've never heard of this one. Look at those hands. Are they small hands? And he referred to my hands. If they're small, something else must be small. I guarantee you there's no problem.
Damn, son. You just hit with the wow effect.
I call President Obama and Hillary Clinton the founders of ISIS. They're the founders. In fact, I think we'll give Hillary Clinton the, you know, if you're on a sports team, most valuable player, MVP. You get the MVP award. ISIS will hand her the most valuable player award. Her only competition is Barack Obama.
Yo. You gotta love it, man. You gotta love it. Straight savage.
Let me just, you know, he wants to be a tough guy. A lot of times, you'll have, and it doesn't work very well with
how tough is it to take
a lot of times
property from an elderly woman?
Let me talk.
One more of his fighters due to the situation today.
This is why he's a great politician, because that was one of the greatest non-answers I've ever heard. And that's okay.
If I may ask one other question.
Yeah, politicians have a really bad habit of giving non-answers. Giving someone an answer that isn't even an answer. I will give politicians credit for that. They have mastered that ability. Unfortunately, I wish they mastered some other abilities like getting some actual stuff done instead of just enraging folks. But hey, guess we got to vote them all out, huh?
Mr. President, if I may ask one other question, are you worried?
That's enough. That's enough.
Mr. President,
that's enough.
I was going to ask one of the other folks.
That's enough.
Pardon me, ma'am. Mr. President.
That's enough.
You know, she looks just like Hillary Clinton, actually. Is that Hillary? Hillary, is that you? Hillary wants to find out, how do you get these crowds, right? How do you get these crowds? Goodbye, Hillary.
straight boss move. Straight, hey, step aside. Step aside. It's the president of America here. What you doing? Didn't play any games. None. Wow. Gotta love it.
And your father was never considered smart. He was never considered a good senator. He was only a good vice president because he understood how to kiss Barack Obama's ass.
Emotional damage. Oh, no.
Thank you.
Here in the United States, we are alarmed by the new calls to adopt socialism in our country.
Ooh.
America was founded on liberty and independence, and not government coercion, domination, and control. We are born free, and we will stay free.
We can all clap for that. Amen.
Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now, out, he's fired. He's fired!
Well, we had a lot of emotional damage going on in that video there. I hope y'all got as good of a laugh out of that as I did. Man, the savagery. The situation where he was standing there and he pushed the other guy to the side and stood out in front. Like, hey, I'm the president of America. I don't stand behind anybody. You gotta love it. The whole Hillary Clinton situation. Because you'd be in jail. But anyway, hope you guys enjoy your 4th of July. Hope it's a wonderful day for everyone. But anyway, y'all let me know what you thought about all of this in the comment section below. Like, share, comment, and of course, hit that subscribe button before you go. It's right up over there. And if you would like to support the channel more than you already have, my PayPal link is in the description box below. Peace and love. I'm out.